the COPD National Action Plan provides the structure for groups from multiple industries and areas of the country, people who are caring for different patient populations. It provides a framework for us all to focus. And so while the work that we've done in innovation is focusing on that first part of the action plan around empowering patients and families, really all of the steps are important. And it's just about figuring out where our strengths are so that we can kind of come together to move the needle on COPD.
I think the most important thing about the COPD National Action Plan is that it has been a collaborative effort across all of the stakeholder organizations. We've learned from our work in some other areas of lung health, you know, some of the more mature areas maybe, like in tobacco control, that bringing all of the stakeholders together to agree on the priorities and the strategies that are and the messaging that's going to make a difference really helps move the whole field forward faster than lots of different people heading in different directions. And that's what the COPD National Action Plan is doing for us as COPD stakeholders.
Respiratory Health Association has been working closely with NHLBI and the Learn More, Breathe Better campaign for more than 10 years. When we engage NHLBI, we find resources, we find a supportive audience, we find networking opportunities, and we find a common concern for the COPD patient. Dr. Kiley from NHLBI has been out to address groups at Respiratory Health Association twice, and he's well received, and our patients know that their disease, COPD, is getting attention at the federal level, and that's very important to them.
Probably the most palpable progress we've seen is the collaborations and the interactions and the coordination that's happened over the past few years. We have agencies now that never even knew about COPD 4 or 5 years ago, and that's a real accomplishment to be able to push that forward on the federal front.